Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Well, Obamacare's implosion, meltdown, is so unbelievably off the chart, I don't even know what to say. I mean, I know they have disdain for their followers. I know they want to wreck the economy and consolidate it and wreck us like a third world nation. This is what venture, vulture, anti-capitalist, monopoly men do. But I cannot even believe that they're throwing 300,000 people off their health care plans in Florida, hundreds of thousands in places like California, tens of thousands in places like Tennessee. The average premium is more than doubled. It's set to double again in the next 2 years. No one can enroll on healthcare.gov. The few idiots that thought they had just thought that they, you know, had sent off for a Nigerian email. By the way, I've been saying this is like the Nigerian email scam for about 3 weeks, and Ted Cruz started saying that yesterday. And I know Ted Cruz's folks listen to the show, so we love it. And none of it's trademarked or copyrighted, only Infowars.com and stuff like that. So knock yourselves out. No, they're all tuning in the broadcast because that's what it is. The problem is, as I predicted, like the Nigerian email scams, folks are going to keep doubling and tripling and quadrupling down, and they're not going to get mad at Obozo and his controllers because he is Christ to them. He's O-Vomit, Obozo. The guy that opens his mouth and flies fly out like it's a horror movie. Everywhere he goes, people pass out. There's a smell of sulfur in the area, reportedly. I'm not kidding. That's and flies coming out of his mouth like he's got a latrine in there or something. But for us, we hate his guts. But for the follower, I'm telling you, folks, he could stab them in the eyes with ice picks, and they would help grab his hand and ram the ice pick in, begging. Because their whole world is about being failures and losers and being conned. By the way, I walked in a restaurant last night to pick up food for my family because my wife was out, and so I was going to bring some food home. And a guy opens the door, walks out past me, and says, "Don't let this guy in here." And I thought he was joking, and then he was like bugging his eyes out at me, freaked out, and had a totally trendy gait about him and his whole demeanor and... And my gaydar was going off as well. And I'm not against that guy because he was, if he wasn't gay, then Liberace wasn't. But the whole point was he obviously thinks I don't like Obama, so I hate gay people, which is not the case. I mean, I'm not obsessed with it all day like the Democratic Party is and then uses it as like the new culture or whatever. I don't like it being pushed on kids. I don't like any sex being pushed on kids. I don't like Jocelyn Elders, you know, saying reach down and help them do it. And that pervert voice of hers. We've got to help the little ones. I mean, that creeps me out. Wouldn't, if it was an old black lady or a white guy, whatever, keep your hands off the children's, you know what? I mean, you're a bunch of government crazy people. The point is that this guy really looked at me like he wanted to attack me, like the door had swung open and there was the hostess right there and Satan himself had entered in. And I'm sorry. Flies aren't landing all over me or coming out of my mouth or spontaneously combusting or generating out of my rumpus. Actually, that's where flies come from. Did you know that, kids? When Obama goes to the bathroom, just trillions of fly eggs spew out and he sprays it all over the wall like a Pollock painting. And then bureaucrats hatch out and fly off. Okay. I got to stop right there. We have a family audience. You got the idea from the CNN bathrooms. Well, no, I didn't know that. Obama's actually been in that studio. He did that artwork. That's why they didn't remove the crap splattered all over the walls at the CNN restroom, was because that's an original. Who's the guy that paints in New York and London that people are mad when they paint over it? He's a great artist. What's his name? He does like Banksy. Yeah. You don't paint over that. You don't paint over an Obama explosive birth of flies. I mean, that's what goes on. And in fact, he's actually not Satan. He's the devil's wife, and those are his babies. All right, I'm going to stop with the potty humor. I know Karl Rove's probably listening, really enjoying it. We're going to come back, get to all the serious news, and it's serious. Stay with us. Now, again, here are some of the headlines up on Infowars.com. And then I'll give you some of the drudgereport.com headlines where you get the most extensive coverage of the O-Rapacare, the O-Scamacare. And, I mean, this is the emperor's new clothes. I mean, this is the most butt-naked fraud openly in front of everybody I've ever even imagined. And the Democrats are now saying this is the new way. We pay double. We pay triple. It doesn't cover pre-existing. Obama won't ever talk about it at press conferences. No one even asked him. If Carney's asked about it, he just walks off the stage. And now they've got you that don't have insurance filing for your free insurance. And instead, you're just going to get your wages garnished by $5,000. That's official. So totally evil. You know, it's like a wild animal coming into the barn thinking it's going to get some grain, a deer or something. And then there's really somebody with a crossbow up in the rafters and shoots you between the eyes. I mean, it's just pure harvesting you. The IRS calls you inventory and human resources. For the foreign banks that have absolutely enslaved and destroyed every other economy, they get their slimy mitts on. And they always put in a paramilitary to control everybody. Well, it's now official. Big states are having up to 300,000 people kicked off a week. More are coming. Millions nationwide are being kicked off their insurance and being told you got to re-up, and it's double. And you better re-up now. We'll give you discounts. It may be triple or quadruple in the next 2 years. So it shouldn't be called Obamacare. It should be called bend over care. Actually, stick your head in the guillotine care. And let me tell you, their supporters, as I predicted, L-O-V-E, love it. Because they can't admit they've been conned. That's why they're failures. They are delusional. Baby, I'm sorry I broke your nose and knocked your teeth out. I guess you're a $10 whore now instead of a $500 whore. This is how he's talking to American people. You're lucky I don't kill you and throw you in the river. Now get to work. And they get down on their knees and they say, yes, sir. And he goes, good, and just punches them right in the eye. And they say, thank you, daddy. And then he just gives them an uppercut and breaks their jaw and says, you know what? Don, take her out back, blow her head off, and throw her in the river. And get those cops on the payroll to help. They do a high five right there. They just love it. You beg for it, and you're going to get more of it. Don't you worry. Homeland Security standing by, training with targets of George Washington. By the way, they pretty much are. They say that's their enemy. SEAL veteran military leaders being asked if they will disarm Americans. That headline's not even hardcore enough. SEAL veteran military training to kill Americans. That's, and by the way, that's in the documents. I mean, they train to destroy America. And so some of the military is waking up. They should. I mean, come on.